now we have Sarvangasana shoulder stand, which, yes, is definitely not an easy asana for me. I have neck issues, and so I always use props or do it in some supported way. This time I'm using blankets, sort of a really classical style, but you know, again, do what you normally do and choose your support. So I'm going to lie back and my shoulders, my neck is supported on the prop and my shoulders are a little further away from the edge because by the time I get up, they will move in that direction. And then I'm going to lift up my bottom and interlace my arms underneath my back so that I can get on top of my shoulders rather than my neck, because it is a shoulder stand, and try to get really high into my thoracic back as much as possible up by my bra strap, and then taking the legs up to the ceiling. If you are actually against a wall with your feet to the wall, you could get in close and, just like I was using the bed, you could actually have your legs up the wall so that you're lifting your hips up and your feet can stay on the wall. You know, so that is actually, if you need to do a more supported version, that would be absolutely acceptable. So we are up there for 10 minutes or however long you can actually stay up there for comfortably. And I just want to show you another version that you could do. So over here I have so I'm using two bolsters against the wall. Some people can even use one. And I'm coming into near lumba, shalambhasana. And so I'm taking my hands to the very edge of the bolster and dropping my shoulders onto it, and then walking myself back up to the wall. And I actually didn't get in close enough, partly because the rug is slipping. There, that's better. So I really need to get my shoulders back towards the wall. And then I can go up. So this is really great for me today. I feel very light up here and absolutely like I'm floating. It's beautiful. It's not always like that. Things are shifting in my body, mind, emotions, and suddenly I can do this, which I'm very grateful for. So to come down, you could slide off the bolsters, trying to move away from the wall, but keep your sacrum on the wall, and then you're in Viparita Karani, which is another pose in this sequence, which comes after such a Sarvangasana, such a kind of Sarvangasana. But also, you know, really nice to come into Viparita Karani after near Lumba Sarvangasana too. And you can even move out of it further by taking your sacrum on the floor and crossing your legs on top of the bolster. You can change the cross of your legs. And then rolling over to the side, coming up. And next we'll do Viparita.